All right, what's up, everybody? Ballet Brand here, as always. So I wanted to add a few more things that I didn't get to cover on my live stream. So shout out to Hexo for doing the stream earlier. Really appreciate all the work. And actually for DJ Cryptomatic, because I do my streams on Sundays, 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and then 7 p.m. Tuesday Pacific Standard Time for Knights at the Crypto Table with, you know, the spinning rotation of the guys that I stream with. But anyway, shout out to DJ Cryptomatic because he was streaming since 1 o'clock and now it's 3:32. So he's been streaming for like 2.5 hours and he's still going strong. But while he's going and while Hexo's done, I wanted to just cover a couple other things that I just wanted to have people take away from the stream that I did last. All right, so when I share the screen, what we can see is, in Hex, there's always been like subtle, I shouldn't say subtle problems, but things that people thought were going to be like major problems. And in the end, in the longer term frame, they didn't last very long. And I think the fees is one of them. Thanks to Richard for doing PulseChain. You can find out more at t.me/pulsechain.com. But let me just go over to the tweet real quick of Richard talking about what this S-load and what this S-load function and what this Berlin fork did. So Ethereum bros, are you wondering why everything on Ethereum is so much more expensive than normal? Partly because Vitalik Buterin and MH Swendy wrote a proposal to increase the cost of reading from disk 2.7x. It was deployed yesterday. So this is actually a really, really big factor. And it's something that, honestly, it hasn't been covered enough necessarily, and I think it's going to continue getting a lot more attention from just the hexagons that had, say, the shorter time frame stakes or even the shorter amount of stakes. I mean, I saw someone post earlier today, they had $50 of hex a year ago that now is worth $650, but to end the stake for them at the time was like $550. So are they going to take such a big hit and pay the Ethereum miners just to take $100 of, it would actually be $50 profit, right? Because if you started with 50 and you got 100, then that's $50 profit. So it's a serious problem. And Richard talks about on his most recent stream, he's got kind of like an internal deadline for himself on when he wants certain things to be done and aspects of PulseChain done. The interesting thing about PulseChain compared to Hex is Hex was completed, locked, no admin keys, audited, all before the contract itself was launched. The thing that Richard was asked on the most recent stream was, is Hex going to be audited before launch? Or sorry, not is Hex. Is PulseChain going to be audited before the launch? And the answer that he said was no, because it's like 300,000 lines of code versus like 23,000, which is Hex, roughly 23, I think. And so the point is, things are going to be a little bit different, right? Richard mentions that if you've got a copy of your machine and you got a piece of paper with text written on it, well, when you copy it, now you've got two pieces of paper with that same exact text and same color and whatnot written on it. So Richard kind of mentions, and this is the first time that we're actually hearing about it. He alluded to it earlier, but about possibly all of the ERC-20 tokens getting this airdrop and getting some use of this fork. And no one has the absolute answers at the end of the day. But what we do know is just like when Hex was in its development stage and when Richard was looking for community input for the inflation rate, for supply and logo and stuff like this, that was all done through community effort and iteration. And what you can do today is go to t.me/pulsechain.com. And you can also contribute to the development of Pulse and give ideas to Richard for how the game theory should work. So far, Richard's mentioned that it'll be a faster fee-burning Ethereum hard fork. And he's mentioned that with the Hex side of things, he doesn't want to give it preferential treatment because then it's just going to get gatekept like Hex did. Because if all these other people with the ERC-20 tokens see that Hex gets some sort of, like I said, special treatment or golden glove, white glove treatment, then they're going to say like, okay, well, why should I be incentivized to stay on here why don't I just dump this and go to the Ethereum network instead? So Richard's definitely playing with a lot of the game theory from what I can tell. And I think it's really cool to see, but it's also something that is kind of just a more immediate problem. The 2.7x in the sload function, like I said, is now affecting people's stakes where I get a lot of people asking me like, okay, should I hold Liquid? Should I end my stake? And should I let that end stake due to the gas fees? Should I let some of that go to the Ethereum miners, or should I just let it bleed? And should I just wait for the Pulse chain to come out and then end the stake on the Pulse chain and then end the stake on the Ethereum chain after the Pulse chain comes out? So there's a million different things that you can do. But I think that the thing that we can learn now is when HEX first came out, you know, obviously it was HEX on Ethereum and the Ethereum fees weren't congested at the time. And it was maybe like a penny to start the stake. And even to end the stake too, it was maybe like 2 pennies at the time. I know because I had like a week long stake that I wanted to test the concept out of. But now we can see that Richard mentions we could have the same solution with Pulse Chain, where Pulse Chain will go back to the low fees and things like that. But you really have to ask yourself, like, okay, when you're doing a staking ladder, and if you're considering multiple stakes, when you're, say, you've never heard of HEX, but you've heard of CDs, and you want to get into HEX because you hear it's the next great thing, and you want to get on the ground floor, well, do you just do one stake, or do you do 15 stakes, or how many is the right number for you? And I guess that's definitely something that is obviously personal, and it's interdependent between what your scenario is and kind of where your time horizon is. But just the one thing I could say is just please be mindful and aware of this change, because the fork itself, the Berlin fork, hasn't really impacted, from what I've noticed, it hasn't necessarily impacted the start stakes or even the transfers from what I've seen, but it's generally the end stake where that sload has to store the data and it has to recall those previous days of data to account for, you know, your HEX interest and your HEX gains. It's something to consider because this is the short term and immediate term. And obviously it's something that Richard Hart's working hard on. He mentions 15,000 to 25,000 US dollars a day are going to Ethereum miners. And what are the Ethereum miners doing? Are they locking it in proof of stake? No, they're dumping it for their electricity bills because it's a proof of work. It's a proof of waste. So it's just something I want to cover because no one knows when Pulse Chain's going to come out. I mean, Richard mentions that it could be sooner than the 6 months that he projected, but we also don't have a glass ball where we can kind of predict what's going to happen. I mean, Richard also talks about the smallest thing, like one bug or just one feature, something that's missing can cause just many months in time spending to fix it and to program it a certain way. So definitely wanted to do this video to let you know just one last point about the fees themselves. Don't be staking daily and expect to not get screwed and pummeled in fees. The fees are definitely something that I don't think people that are new to HEX, I don't think they're considering before they stake. And I've got friends, I mean, right? You got friends that you did stakes for or family members that you gave some HEX to. And now when you see the actual the fees going up so exorbitantly, well, now it's like, okay, do I cash out this little bit of profit for them, or do I just let it bleed and wait for the Pulse chain fork to come out and then just cash it out there? It's definitely a dilemma that no one has the answer to. All we can do is kind of just take the current worldview that we're at and update our opinions, our strategies, our tactics for how we're going to go on in the future. And for me, like I mentioned, I'm pretty much staked out. I mean, any future stakes will probably be either every 6 months or every year, because otherwise I just don't see this reason and this need for a stake every single month. I mean, if it's anytime soon, that doesn't make sense. If it's anytime out in the future, you're honestly kind of just diluting the gains that you would have had, because you would have had more T-shares if you had just done it in a lump sum 15 years out, as opposed to 15 years out and then every month subsequently. So these are just some things I wanted to cover. Thank you, Hexo, for the video. Thank you, Richard, for the 8-hour-long live stream. And to Kareem and to Toby One for kind of co-hosting and moderating the chat at the time. It was the first time that Richard had almost like a Clubhouse experience where you have people on Android and iOS, thanks to Telegram, on t.me/hexcrypto. You had them interacting with Richard via the raise hand function. And I thought that was great. When I saw Richard, he had streamed for maybe like an hour and 30 minutes, something like that, about 90 minutes before the first call. And when I could see the concept of the call and Richard going, I was like, you know what, this is going to be a long stream, because Richard's being more, it's more interactive, it's more engaging. And so that was awesome to see. And that was really cool for Richard to do another 8-hour live stream. So thanks for all the work you do, Richard. For the people that don't get it, he's obviously hard at work. So try not to bug him on DMs of questions on Pulse Chain and how things are going to work. If you have any questions or desire to contribute, you should do so on the Telegram, as opposed to direct messaging someone and filling up their inbox. So go to t.me/pulsechaincom or t.me/hexcrypto. But the pulsechaincom is where Richard wants any advice or any game theory that you might have before it gets implemented into the Ethereum hard fork, which is going to be Pulsechain as we know it. So that's all I wanted to say. Hope everyone's doing well. The shirt that I'm wearing is quite relevant to Hex, right? We covered it during my stream, but just one last thing before I leave is the actual price itself. So this is just version one, but we can just see where the chart is going, and it is going up and to the right. And then when we go to version two, it should still save the data that I wrote earlier. So I mean, on a daily basis, we're down just a little bit from where we were last week. I mean, we're down about 12%, but some people, they consider that an opportunity, right? As opposed to buying these tips, if you can buy some of the consolidation, then you'll probably do pretty well, especially if you already have a certain investment strategy and tactics that are not going to let you trade it, but let you accumulate wealth slowly but surely. So that's all I really have. Just wanted to say the last few things regarding the gas. And the other thing I'll say is this isn't the only, I mentioned it before, but this isn't just affecting hexagons, right? That S load function, I mean, I would guess to do stuff like tornado.cash, I would guess that end stake is going to be a lot more expensive than the input, because when you're ending it, you have to account for the 8 days or the week or however long you go of it mixing. So that's going to be more expensive too. And Richard's always looking for solutions, and he's always looking for innovative ways to make Hex better and to make the system itself better. And so shout out to Richard for doing that. Thank you for all your hard work. It definitely doesn't go unnoticed. I mean, people like Gary, Funding Jim have mentioned that, I mean, not only is he grateful for Richard for doing Hex and the life-changing wealth that's caused, but also for just the advice in general, and just, I shouldn't say advice, but like the information that he's provided in general. Even when I was following him in 2017, Richard had SciVive, and it was pre-edited, right? And it was super choppy and like 300,000 something words, but it goes to show you that Richard has always been authentic and legit and true to himself, first off, before he was truthful to everyone else. And I want to say that definitely doesn't go unnoticed. I mean, Richard's always been, he's always been the most honest person in crypto that I've ever known. And that's after seeing a space that's rife with a lot of pump and dumpers and a lot of scammers and just a lot of people that don't have your best interest in mind. When Richard talks about trading destroys your health, I mean, I experienced it personally. You know, I remember 2017 where I had some altcoins aside from the major caps. And I remember waking up at 3 a.m. and setting alarm clocks and whatnot just to see if my trade was doing good, or just to see where the market was, because the market's so volatile that by the time you go to sleep, it can pump a whole bunch or dump a whole bunch too. So the fact that I don't have to have that be a current problem where I'm experiencing the stress and the gut-wrenching dips from trading is amazing, right? It's amazing to be able to spend the time with your loved ones, health, wealth, you know, stuff like that. And I just want to say a shout out to Richard for all you do. I mean, he incentivized people to not only buy and hold crypto, which is what crypto, since crypto is the highest appreciating asset class, if you're buying and holding it, generally you're going to do well. Obviously, if it's got product market fit and if it's not just some random coin that goes to zero. But then he created something even better that incentivizes you to lock it, which slows down the velocity of money. So just want to say that's really cool, Richard. HEX is designed to be the global reserve currency. And out of everything that I've ever seen, I've never seen anything more magical than HEX. I've never seen anything more powerful and invigorating. Like it's got such a unique attraction to it that it almost pulls you in. Like for myself, I never planned to do streaming. I'd done videos in the past on my YouTube channel that I've had since I was like 11, but I've never like been compelled to do streaming about crypto until HEX came out. So thank you for everyone watching. Had a whole bunch of people watching today on the live stream. There's like 63 people watching, and it's awesome to be able to converse with everyone and see what your guys and gals' opinions are regarding some of the thoughts that I have and just regarding the crypto space in general, because it changes in the blink of an eye. And because the market goes 24/7 and it's not like the traditional stock market that has, you know, on and off switches and things like that, it's just a different beast. And like I mentioned, some of the things that work in the stock market don't work in crypto. And some of the things that work in crypto don't work in the stock market. So it's not directly related where, you know, you have one success here and now you can bring those same strategies to crypto and it's going to be the same success. So the thing that I've learned the best is, yeah, if you have a longer time horizon, like with Bitcoin, even if you had held it for 3 years, if that was your time horizon was 3 years, then you were never down on your Bitcoin because it's always gone back up and made newer all-time highs after the bear market. So that's all I'll say there. The other thing I'll say real quick regarding, say, Doge, the Doge pump. I was with my brothers Friday night, had some dinner, and the waiter himself was talking about crypto and Doge and had his Doge on Robinhood and just a whole bunch of cringe in my head. But the point is this, is the opportunity in the space itself is rife with so much adoption and so much abundance. And with things like HEX that have always been like Mr. Reliable and Mr. Trusty Dusty, you know, it's like the choo-choo train. No matter, I don't know, I guess how many people try and throw like sticks and rocks at the train, you know, the train just keeps on chugging along, keeps on going. So it's still going up and to the right. And the FUD and whatnot almost validates HEX, right? If someone notices that you exist, generally you're going to get some hate. You're going to get people that love it and love you, but you're also going to get some hate. And especially with someone like Richard Hart that has had honest intentions the whole time and called out the scammers and called out the fake Satoshis, people like him do get hate from the people that are the worst actors in the space. And the more that we can kind of realize that that's the games that are being played from the influencers, from the people that have something to benefit off of you, then the more you realize people like Richard have just been spitting truth since day one. So that's all I'm going to say. Thanks, guys. We had to end the stream earlier due to Hexo and DJ Cryptomatic was still streaming. But yeah, you know, shout out to all the streamers, right? There's definitely this never-ending content of Hexagon information, live streams, videos, like Crypto Coffee talks about, a lot of evergreen content that Hexagons are providing. So I'm happy to do the streams with everyone. And thanks. We'll see you on the next one. I'll see you guys next Tuesday, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Knights of the Crypto Table. Just watch out for my retweet, whichever channel we're rotating on. It's not going to be mine this week. It might be Crypto Coffee or someone else. Dollar Cost maybe this week too. So we'll see, but I'll see you guys next time. And yeah, just make sure you know what you're doing before you stake. Otherwise, you might want to hold it liquid until you know what you're doing. Thanks.